Could you grab a picture of her, please? You have the picture, you have the camera in your hand. Hi, girl. I'm Jennifer. Hi, sweetie.
Yeah, right, man.
Justin, help your grandpa. Do you see where Jennifer went?
Yeah, she's walking in right
now. There she is.
She just sat down. She's the eighth one.
There she is.
Oh, good. We're in a good spot.
Yeah, we are. Great spot. I don't see her.
James River Assembly for allowing us the opportunity to share. The use of this facility tonight, the beautiful weather we're having, allows approximately 1,500 more people to share this event than would be possible if we conducted it in our existing high school gymnasium.
Yeah.
The class of 2003 that we're here to honor tonight has been a distinguished class. They'll be remembered as a group of very talented young people who have been successful both in their own individual rights as well as collectively as a group. This class entered kindergarten, at least those who've been in Ozark for 13 years, in the fall of 1990 with an enrollment of 190 students. Tonight, we will present diplomas to 226 seniors. Woo! Each of you who know graduates here tonight will have different memories about their educational careers and their time in Ozark schools. Whether you remember this class as being a part of the class 4A State Boys Basketball Championship, the first title in basketball that Ozark has been able to enjoy in 53 years, or whether you remember this class as the last graduating class to graduate from our existing high school. By the way, this is the 40th class to graduate from that building, 40 classes graduating from that high school building. Or whether your memories of this class are more personal to individuals and to yourselves, the important thing to remember is that this class will always be remembered very fondly, both as a part of history of our school and of our community, but also as a part of our hope for the future. Again, we express our deepest gratitude to you for being here to share this. We sincerely hope this is an enjoyable evening for you. Thank you.
Even though we all have our own unique experiences, we can relate to each other because of them. All of us standing up here today are distinctly different, but through our common goals, we stand up here together. Every event from elementary until now has helped us overcome obstacles and prepared us for the challenges to come. Looking back at kindergarten, everything seems so simple. From milk time to recess, or even nap time and story time, it's hard to imagine that we fit it all into only a half day. It's funny how the little things, such as sharing, playing games at recess, and being told not to run with scissors, have established the foundation we have been building on for the past 13 years.
Not only did we get to choose our own classes, but we no longer had to walk down the halls in a single file.
file line or sit in alphabetical order at lunch. We are also able to get involved in things we are interested in, whether it be through clubs, sports, or classes. We experienced our first school dances, although they mostly consisted of the girls standing around talking and the boys playing basketball in the gym. Along with our freedoms came new challenges. We are suddenly having to balance 7 classes instead of just 1, not to mention our extracurricular activities. We are also faced with the challenge of not getting our team card signed and keeping our birthday a secret from Mrs. Barnett for fear of her singing her famous birthday song. From our first day as subbies to 8th grade weekend, we are touched by teachers, friends, and events that we are hard to forget.
I do not think that many of us could forget the time that Coach Klein was diagnosed with Lou Gehrig's disease. This is one of my most distinct memories, as well as an experience that continues to change my outlook on life. I did not know Coach Klein very well at the time, nor could I have pronounced the name of the disease he was diagnosed with. I knew it was serious, though. I watched him day in and day out strive to make a difference in this world, which made me realize that life is nothing to take for granted, that each second is precious. Also, he has taught me to take full advantage of the time I have and to be thankful for everything, no matter how insignificant it may be. Coach Klein was my junior high gym coach, then my teacher and basketball coach in high school. I saw him every day. He always had a smile on his face. He always wanted to hear about our boyfriends, and whatever one needed or had to say, he was always there. Although he may not know it, Coach Klein became a mentor of me and one of whom I admire greatly. I remember when he would yell at me in practice, and even though I could not understand the word he spoke, I knew it meant. I was not trying hard enough. He always pushed me to be the best that I could be in everything that I did. Coach Klein's faith in God and strength has showed me that most anything is possible if you believe. Rodney Klein may not have changed the world, but I know one perspective that he has changed.
In making the transition to high school, a change is vital. Not only must you change schools, but you also must go from being leaders on campus down to the bottom of the totem pole. Suddenly, riding the bus is not so cool. And you're plagued with things such as voice changes, braces, and constant teasing of intimidating upperclassmen. All through junior high, you've been awaiting this time, but once you arrive, you can't wait to get older. This is a time when identities begin to form and lifelong friends are made. Changes in clothing, attitudes, interests, and standards take place. People either decide to stand strong or crumble under adversity. Coming into high school was especially important for me because I was forced to move from a different state. The small town of Ozark was not my idea of a glamorous place at first, and my freshman year was full of complaints and wishes to go back to Oregon. But as my sophomore year came, I was beginning to accept and adjust to my surroundings. I began to enjoy the friendliness of the small town environment, and school involvement helped me to make new friends. I also was plugged into a wonderful church with people who loved me and pastors who helped disciple me in my walk with the Lord. I will never forget the impact that these new friends and mentors had on my life. From going to state with the soccer team to going on church retreats, awesome memories and connections were made with my fellow students and which will stay with me always. Freshman year in the past, and we were ready for something bigger. There was no more wandering the halls, trying to figure out where your next class was. We were more familiar with everything around us. All those long bus rides to school and back were no longer a problem either. We could now drive ourselves. But with our license came many new responsibilities. Most of us would have to go out and find a job of our own, which definitely helped out our parents. We would now understand the concept of time and how there aren't enough hours in the day, especially after driving from work to school each day. After all of that, the little time we had left was spent hanging out with our friends, but we would also manage to find extra time to fit in a day or two. This was also the time when we would spot our true friends from the rest, building very close relationships with them. But we would also form several new ones too. No longer worrying about being the youngest in the school, we were more comfortable getting involved in activities. And we found ourselves slowly fitting in. And as the years went on, we realized it really does get better, and we would be further prepared for what is ahead for us the next 2 years.
No matter who your friends are, you share funny, embarrassing, great, and not so great memories.
Whether it be losing your shirts while sliding through puddles in weights class, junior or senior prom, struggling through classes, or just talking in the halls, the memories you share with your friends form that special bond that keeps you together and brings you closer. Even though we are on the verge of going our separate paths, the strong friendships we have will anchor us through these next few years of our lives.
As I look back through the years I have spent here, I realize that this place has become my second home. Not only do I spend more time here than I do at home, 50 plus hours a week, but over the past 4 years I have realized that if I am ever in trouble, there is always help nearby. My teachers and some of my fellow students have become a sort of extended family for me. While I am excited about moving into the future, I will miss them all very dearly. Senior year, for me and for all of us here today, has been a culmination not only of our mandatory school years, but of our adolescence itself. It feels like this year has been about tying up loose ends. Whether those loose ends are attending all of the games, which we never had time for in the past, or taking those last few hard classes in preparation for college next year. We're always tempted to say, oh well, I can always do that tomorrow. In fact, I had not completed the speech until Wednesday afternoon. Thank you, Ms. Hanlon, for believing me when I told you I'd finish. But this time, there is no tomorrow. From now on, at all times, we will be expected to function as adults. We will no longer be granted the grace and luxury of a warning if we do something wrong. After tonight, as far as our high school careers are concerned, there are only yesterdays. We are all moving onwards and upwards in the world. Whether we are destined for the academic life at college, plan to begin a job that we really love, or have yet to choose a destination, we are all saying our goodbyes to this place and to our beginnings. We should be careful to never forget the things that made it possible for us to be where we are tonight. Not only those of us at the podium now, but all of us here, those of us in the choir loft, and those of us in the stands today. We should thank our peers, our mentors, our parents, and the powers that be that we have all safely made it to this point and are now able to accomplish something for ourselves. With beginnings such as these, we all have the opportunity to shape ourselves and our futures into something great. Do not let the past dictate who you are, but let it be a part of who you become. Thank you all for being here tonight and supporting us through the years. It means so much to us to see you here and to know that you really care. None of us would be here at all if it were not for you.
I will love you more than me and more. going to be here in a year.
He's going to be 13 years.
Man, look
Who's taking a picture? Get in the picture.
You hold that for you?
That's still recording.
Not me. She did all the work. But a mom. All I did is stay out of my hair. Deborah said, I remember the first day. We were here in Ozark, on South Mixup. She put her on the bus the first time for kindergartner. Then we followed the bus to the school. Now tell me that ain't... Get him. Don't do that! Now, please put that down. Put that down. I'll call that friend of mine, have him send me one of an extra video he might have. He owns that company called Video Memories in Texas.
Yeah.
You need to see that. This guy, I mean, it's phenomenal what he does.
I'll bet money. All the stuff that's on the screen, they're going to make a video out of it.
I'm sure they are.
You know, $5 or $10.
Hey! There she is!
Make sure that light comes on.
actually send the, or give the diploma out later. See, I want to see that hat. Let me see this.
What's that really good? Good on. I can't put this inside. You take digital photos?
Yeah.
That's good.
That's fine for now. Keep it all together. It's easier. What's the blue collar? Is that for the
Honor Society?
Honor Society. Yeah.
Why is A+? And the gold straps are the
Victorians. Valedictorians are the gold cords.
Uh-huh.
You never missed it by two grades being a valedictorian.
Seriously, go on your bumper. Ask him.
What?
Should I not go on your bumper?
Yeah, put it on the back bumper of your car so those little feet flap in the wind.
She's so cute! She's so cute. You ready? Okay. You guys ready?
Oh,
are you taking... Oh, I thought you were still... No, I'm taking a picture with you guys.
Oh, you are? What for? Justin, drive him up.
Take way too many. It's always was the one that you missed that you enjoyed.
Well, have you got any with just you and her? And you and you and Drebber and her?
Jennifer, Dad, just go find your key.
I know that.
I know.
One more. Ready?
Thank you, Justin.
Oh, yeah.
Go ahead
and hold it for a minute.
Are you all right, Lennon? Actually, Damon. Nice.
Yeah.
Okay. Friend.
Oh, okay. She was on class with Jamie and Mandy.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
It must be Stephanie.
I am.
You're Dave all the time. I'm Damon. We've met before, have we?
Well, maybe once on the bench.
On the